guys, in today's video, we're going to discuss about the Scammon's curve of growth. So, Scammon's curve of growth is based on the principle of differential growth in the human body, which means to say that not all organs grow at the same time throughout life. So, different organs are growing at different rates to different amounts at different times. So, what he did is that he classified the tissues in our body into four types. The first being lymphoid, neural, followed by general and genital. So if we look at the graph that he's plotted for the size against age, we see that this is the lymphoid growth. So what happens in the lymphoid tissue is that it grows to 200%. Okay, it's growing to 200% by the age of 11 to 13 years. And then it regresses by the adulthood, or by 18 years of age, it undergoes involution to reach the adult size. So your 100 is your adult size, or the maximum size that a tissue reaches. And this goes beyond 100%. So it reaches 200%. Now, if you get the concept, it's obviously because children are more prone to infections. And your lymphoid tissue is basically helping them protect against these infections. Now, with lymphoid tissue, I also want to mention about the fact that, you know, earlier in the definitions of growth, growth was also described as an increase in size. But that definition doesn't hold true for lymphoid tissues, because as age progresses, the lymphoid tissues are actually also decreasing in size. So this is about the lymphoid tissue. Coming to the next one, which is the neural tissue. Now your neural tissue includes the growth of your brain, nervous system, and some associated structures such as the eyes and parts of the skull. Now what happens is these tissues will actually show very rapid growth in your early postnatal life. So if you look at the curve, it's very rapid in your early postnatal life. And then what happens is that then there is only a very slow, steady gain. Okay, after say about like till year, it's very rapid. So till about 7 years, it's very rapid. And then there is only a low steady gain after 7 years of age, with a slight spurt during adolescence. So if you observe in children, they are, at least their brain is full grown by the age of 7 to 8 years. So this is about the neural tissue. The next one is your general tissues. Now, general tissues, or the general or the body curve, it's known as the general or the body curve, which will tell you about the growth of the body as a whole. So if you look at the person's stature, weight, height, all of this is going to be described by the general growth curve. So we actually know this. One important thing that you must remember is the general growth curve is the S-shaped curve. If you look at this curve, you can see that it is a nice S-shaped. So why is it S-shaped? So there are four phases in this growth curve. So the first phase is the rapid growth, which is seen in infancy. So you look at this part, okay? This is your rapid growth, which is seen during infancy. Okay, then your middle childhood, okay? You will see this steady growth, this part of the curve. Then you come to your adolescent phase. So adolescent phase, again you will see that, you know, the child is growing very rapidly. And then you will see that there is slow increase and eventual cessation of growth after adolescence. So you have four parts of the curve: 1, 2, 3, and 4. So when is the curve increasing very fast? It is during two phases. The first phase is infancy and early childhood. And the second phase is during adolescence. That is when your growth spurt is also seen anyway. So that is when your spurt is like, the graph is very steep. But in 2 and 4, that is during your middle childhood and during your adolescence, or after adolescence, you have a slow increase, or you know, you just have a, you don't have a very steep curve in your Scammon's curve of growth. So what you need to remember is the general growth curve is this S-shaped curve. The last one is your genital growth curve. So this curve is basically characterized by slow slight growth in infancy. So you know, this is the latent period for your genital tissues, right? You don't really need them. So these tissues will show slight growth in infancy, which is followed by a latent period where there is like no growth. During most of the childhood, there is no growth of these tissues, and then they experience rapid growth and maturation during the adolescent spurt. So if this is your adolescent spurt, here they are experiencing rapid growth. So these are about the four growth curves which Scammon talks about, and it's really easy to understand because he's classified them into four tissues and he's plotted this curve. So thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you soon in the next video.